given that Congress is back, what's the plan this week in terms of White House engagement with the Senate? And to Republicans who say that this is something that could contribute to inflation, I think there was one Senate Republican who called him the Mad Hatter for pushing for this at a time when inflation is off the hook. What would you say to that?
Well, on the first piece, I would tell you that our team, senior White House officials, have been in close touch already over the last several days on moving our Build Back Better agenda forward. We had some of our senior officials meeting with the Budget Committee over the last several days. I think they had two meetings over the last several days. We had a number of our senior White House officials meeting with Leader Schumer's team last night. So I can assure you we are moving forward full speed to get this done, and we expect action on it in the coming weeks. We will continue to press for that. For anyone who's criticizing, I would say that the way, and we saw, I would say, in recent weeks, even with the votes of Republicans, every Republican in the House went on the record voting against steps that many economists have said would ease inflation. They voted to raise taxes, essentially, on middle-class families, voted for higher child care, prescription drug, and elder care costs, despite claiming they agree inflation and costs are a problem. So we're out there. Democrats in Congress are out there, many of them. We welcome Republican support, I will continue to say, taking steps to lower costs. We know that Build Back Better will start cutting child care costs in half in 2022, make preschool free for many families starting in 2022, lead to the construction of additional housing units starting in 2022. What is the Republican plan for lowering costs, for addressing inflation? Something they are very concerned about, but they don't seem to have any solutions for. I don't know what the Mad Hatter reference is, but that feels like it's more applicable.